Hello, my name is Sally, and today we are going to be talking about fostering. My family started fostering when I was 3 years old. Because they started fostering when I was so young, it feels very normal to me. I do not remember my life before fostering, and I would not have it any other way. The hardest part of fostering is not trying to cope with the naughty or aggressive children. I think saying goodbye to children that you love and is your best friend is the hardest part of fostering. I try to look at it as a positive thing because it is happy for them to move on to either adopted parents, birth parents, or independent adult life. It also means that a new child will come, only meaning new adventures and stories to start together. If a child moves to an adopted parent or an independent adult life, then we normally meet up, but we rarely see the children again if they move back to their birth parents. My favourite memory is when a 3-year-old boy moved in with my family on an emergency placement. An emergency placement is when a child moves in with you without much notice beforehand. The thing was that the 3-year-old boy was deaf, so the only way he could communicate at the time was through sign language. So me and my family had to learn sign language really quickly. When the 3-year-old boy arrived, I tried to explain to him that there were rabbits in the garden, but I signed the words rabbits wrong, so he thought there were cows in the garden, and he started mooing at the cow at the rabbits because he got confused. We fostered a girl called Sally, but my name is also called Sally. This meant that every time I talk about my family to people, everyone gets confused because they are like, you can't have two Sallys. So I then have to explain my whole life story to them, and it is really annoying. My family call me Sally Eva, and they call my little sister Sally Mac. But sometimes my family forget to say Sally Eva or Sally Mac. They just say Sally, and it can be confusing because you don't know who they are talking to. If I was ever very unhappy about a foster placement, my parents would always listen to me, and sometimes they would send the child to another foster carer, or they would give me one-to-one parent and child time. Some examples of my favourite one-to-one parent and child time is Aero Feast, which is Aero hot chocolate in an Aero mug and an Aero chocolate bar, going on a small holiday together for about 1 or 2 nights, dog walking and going out for breakfast. But my parents also sometimes provide one-to-one parent and child time to foster children because the foster children definitely need a break from me because I am crazy. I found the one-to-one parent and child time helpful for me. It meant I always had something to look forward to and keep me happy even when things got tough. I think being treated the same as other foster children is also helpful because even though my parents still love me, they never favourite me in any way. It is also helpful for me as the birth child because it meant that the foster children would never get jealous of me, so making friends with them is easy. It is also good for the foster child because it makes them feel like an important part of the family. Thank you for watching. Bye.